Now, end is near, so I face final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled east.
Hi folks, I have been, I received a request for a tutorial on how to make a beaded collage pendant. And I'm showing you an example of one right there now. And I'll switch it out. Here's another one that I made. And it's kind of flattering to get a request for a video. So I thought I would try it. I'll show one more. This one is one of my favorites for colors. Some of these are on a Kumihimo braid that I already did a tutorial on a short time ago. So I thought we would give it a shot. What do we need to do this is, first of all, you need some wire, and you might want to start with 20 gauge for the frame, then 24 gauge or 26 gauge for the weaving part, adding other beads to it. So today I've started out with the 20 gauge copper wire, like so. I'm going to adjust the so you could see a little more of what I'm doing. Okay. Start out with about a 10 or 12 inch piece. Okay, and I don't know if you can see it, like so. And I kind of straighten it out with my fingers a little bit. That'll harden it just a bit. I don't know why. There's some scientific reason for that. And I have a dowel. I go about in the middle of the wire, right about there. And I'm going to twist, I should say wrap. Wrap around once on one side, bringing it close together. Wrap around again on the other side. So you have something that looks like this. Get it into the camera there. See? Okay. Now that's your wrap. So you bring the two pieces together underneath, and you want to give it a twist up close to the dowel and one more time to secure it. Now this is the width of your chain or your braid or whatever you're going to wear it on as a chain. So you can use a dowel to match it, a smaller or larger. Okay? And then you think, well, the cord is going to go through here. So you want to end up with your bead wire for your frame going this way. Because the cord will go through here and then it will hang properly. Okay, so we got that done. The next thing we do is to load, what I would say, load the beads. And I'll bring my bead tray over. And I just have a collage of beads, a collection of all the beads I have. I've gotten them different places, but whatever you want. Now this cord, this Kumihimo cord, by the way, I'm talking Kumihimo, let me just show you. This is the Kumihimo weave disc, okay? In case you need to look it up. This Kumihimo cord will be what I'm going to wear this new pendant that I'm making on. So it will hang like this. Let me go in a little closer on that. There. Okay. So that's what we're aiming for. Let me get that off. Now I'm going to load my beads. And by that I just mean I'm going to add the beads on both sides, and then I'm going to make a circle or a square shape. I'm not going to take up a lot of time showing you all this, but notice some of the colors I want to keep in mind. There's a lot of reds, so I'll put some red on there. And I think I'll put a couple small beads. Whoops, there goes one. Hope the dog doesn't eat it. All right, and another red. So let me go ahead and load these, and then I'll stop the camera and load these on, and then I'll pick it up again. Be back in a minute. Okay, now I have got the beads loaded on the frame, and I'm going to bring it up close to the camera so you can see it. Hope that shows up. And I'm going to attempt to do some bending to shape it. And I'm trying to figure how the best way. Yeah, maybe that would be the best. Okay. At the very ends, I curled them with the round nose pliers. I don't know if you can see that. Okay, so if I work down here, okay, I really need a videographer or whatever you call those guys. Okay, here we are. So I'm going to shape this. I think I'll go like so. You never know what you're going to get, so I'll go across like this. Okay. And then I might bring this one. It's kind of stiff wire, so I have to use a little pressure, not too much. Got that. Now I might come up around. I'll always try to not make it too big. I have a tendency to go overboard sometimes. Also, when you first load your beads, don't make them too tight, because if you do, then you'll have trouble bending and a bead might break, but it's no great loss. You're just going to lose one bead. It's not a big deal. Okay, now we've got this shape so far, but you see we have these two ends sticking up here. That's not a good thing. That in there a little better. Okay, that's not such a good thing. So what I'm going to do is go to my smaller gauge wire, this, and cut off about 10 inches, and then I'm going to load some small beads on there. And as soon as I do that, I'll be right back. Now I've loaded some very small seed beads onto the fine wire. I've curled the end with my round nose pliers here, and I've left the tail over here. Now the next thing I'm going to do is take this end that is open and twist it around any spot that I can find over here and to secure it. And then I'm going to wrap this cord, this wire with the beads on it, interweave it in and out, till it comes out to be a nice shape and sort of gives it some more stability. I secured the small wire with the beads on it to the bale right here. And now I'm going to wrap it around the top to hide a little bit of the wire. And this will be the front. This will be the back. And I still have this unsecured one, which I will get to later. But right now, I'll just take a moment to wrap this to give it a little more interest. Wrap it in here. And let's see, I can go any place I want to. So, looks a little. You can always change your mind. Go bring it up through here. Wire is very forgiving. And I think I'll go in through there. And I want to connect these two maybe with another bit of beaded wire. Okay, that doesn't look too bad. But you get the idea. You start out with your heavy gauge and your dowel. And by the way, I'm going to take my dowel and put it in here because I want to always remember that it's going to hang this way. You can add more and more and more if you want to. I'm not quite finished with this one because I need to secure those two in the back, but I think I'm going to add another one of the thin wire with the beads on it, and maybe all in pink or something to go with that braid. Okay, be back. Just about finished now. I added the dowel back on to make sure I'm going to keep that shape for my braid. And now I'm just going to do a little pushing and mashing and shaping so that the back is flat. And I'll flip it over. This will be the back. But it's really kind of pretty. You could use that as the front. It's really reversible. And then this will be the front. And I'll remove the dowel. Put on the braid. And I think it looks pretty nice. So basically, to review, you take a dowel, use your thicker wire, make your bale, load your beads, then shape it into some sort of a frame, take smaller gauge wire, add smaller beads, and secure it to the frame, wrap it around, intertwine it, and just have fun with it, you know. They're all going to look entirely different. And when you're done, you'll know. And if you're not satisfied with it, just add a few more beads. Thanks for watching. And there'll be more to come. Bye-bye.